Good morning, students. In continuation with the circle, today we see the property of sum of measures of an arc. If you see this figure, here is a circle and it has arcs BC, CD, DE, EF and BC. These are the arcs of a circle. Okay. Now, these points BC, D, EF, these are concyclic points. The meaning of it is that they lies on a circle. Concyclic means B, C, D, E, F. These points lies on a circle. And these points are forms the arcs. Means arc BC, arc CD, otherwise arc BD, arc CE, DE. These are the arcs of the circle and these points forms the arc. Okay. There is one and only one common point C. This is the common point C in arc ABC and CDE. This is arc, here is A. This is arc ABC. Means suppose from here to here. This is the point C is common. And in another CDE, CDE. This point C is the common point C. So the measure of ACE, ACE, sum of arc, sorry, measure of arc ACE, measure of arc ACE is equal to measure of arc, measure of arc ABC plus measure of arc ACE, we are looking ACE. So ABC plus EDC or CDE. Okay. In this way, we are writing the sum of measure of arcs of this. But now next, but ABC and this is the ABC. This is ABC arc and another is the BC D. If we add these both arcs, then what which arc we will get? A B D, otherwise A C D. So here I will write measure of arc A B E is equals to, means here is A, here is B and E. Measure of arc A B E is equals to, which will come, you just add this A B C plus C D E. Measure of arc ABC plus measure of arc CDE. In this way we can add this. But if you are writing ABC plus BC, ABC, okay, what I said ABC, we are taking this arc ABC and plus measure of arc we can take BCE. What I said BCE, measure of arc B, C, E. Then is this statement is correct? Is it correct or wrong? If you see this, in first ABC inside, this arc we are measuring. Which? A, B, C. And second inside B, C, E. Here is B, C, E. If you notice, the BC, arc BC is repeating in both that. So, measure of arc A, B, E is not equal to measure of arc A, B, C, plus measure of B, C, E. Okay. If you want to measure, end point we have to take here A, B, C plus C, D, E. This is the property of sum of measures of arc. What we have to do? We have to add the arcs from the end points. If you see here, here is C and we are starting it also from the C. And sum of all arcs of a circle is, how much it is there? It is 360 degree. Okay. After that, we will see the theorem. Now, here is a theorem. The chords corresponding to congruent arcs. The chords corresponding to congruent arcs of a circle or congruent circles are congruent. That is the statement. So, inside it, first of all, we have to draw the circle with center. This is circle. Center I will draw here. B. Okay. So, what we have to do here? We have to take two arcs which are, suppose I took here A, C is the arc here, and one more arc is here, that is suppose this is point D, and how much is the measure of AC? Same measure is of DE. Okay, and now I will join this. So here is AC and this is DE, and I draw the radius of I join the center of the circle and these points, that is AC and DE. Now I will join AC. If AC is arc, this is AC arc and here is AC chord. Same way here is DE is a arc of a circle and this is the chord of a circle. Okay. Now from the information, from the figure, we will write the given for this theorem. So what will be the given? The chords correspond to congruent arcs. Now AC and DE, these are the corresponding chords which have which are AC and DE, these are the corresponding congruent arc, and inside AC and DE are there, and those are congruent, we have to prove, means we have to prove that AC is congruent to DE. Okay, so for that, first of all, in a circle, given we will write, in a circle, center is which? Center B. In a circle with center B, okay, what is there? Arc, this is AC, otherwise I will name here P, and here I will name Q, which APC, arc APC is congruent to arc DQE. DQE. It is given. Means this, if these arcs are congruent, then these chords are also congruent, that we have to show. So what we have to prove? We have to prove that, that is AC is congruent to DE. What? Chord AC is congruent to chord DE. And this theorem is there in the textbook, in the form, in activity based it is there. Okay. And now we are solving. What we have to show? If this chord APC and EQD are congruent, then chord AC is also congruent to ED, that we have to proof. Okay, now we'll see the proof. So first of all, we will take here two triangles are there. First triangle is ABC and another is the DBE. So in triangle ABC and another triangle is DBE. DBE. So this is ABC and this is DBE. These triangles, if these two triangles are what? Similar. If we show the similar to each other, congruent to each other, then these two chords also we can show congruent to each other. Okay. So first of all, AB is congruent to, this AB is major. AB is congruent to which side we will take? Here BD. Okay. Because radius of the same circle. Side AB is congruent to side BD. Reason is, here they shown bracket and blank space given, so you have to write radii of same circle. Radii of same circle. Okay. Now next term, here given side dash congruent to side, in this way shown, and here you have to, this is the activity, so here the blank space given, and in this way another dash given, and here bracket inside we have to write the what? It's a reason. Okay. So first of all, here side, another which side is there? This is BC is congruent to BE. So I will write here BC is congruent to BE, and the reason is same, that is the radii of same circle. Okay, and next angle, this angle ABC is congruent to angle DBE. Tell me the reason. Its reason is that which angle ABC is congruent to DBE. The reason behind it is that the measures of congruent have. If AC is congruent to ED, then this is the central angle. Then if AC is APC, arc APC is congruent to arc EQD, then angle ABC is congruent to DBE, because these are the central angles or measure of congruent arcs. And we seen this from the activity that if these arcs are this radius and arc, when the radius and arcs are congruent, then these angles are also congruent. Otherwise, measure of angle is same. These angles are same and radius are also congruent, then only arcs are congruent. Okay, and that we seen in the activity in our last lecture. Measure of congruent arcs. Okay, now here if you see, this side AB is congruent to D, means AB and DE. BC is congruent to BE. Okay, and this is the angle in between these two sides. Okay, which angle B and here, sorry, ABC and here DBE. These two angles are also congruent to each other. Therefore, these two triangles, which ABC and DBE, are congruent to each other. By which test of similarity? That is SAS test of similarity. In your textbook, in this way given, in therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DBE, and reason is the here blank space given, you have to write here SAS test of similarity. Sorry, congruence. SAS test of congruence. If these two triangles are congruent to each other, then the remaining side, that is AC, is congruent to ED, and reason behind it is that CSCD. Therefore, we will write here SAG or chord AC is congruent to chord ED. Okay, and reason is that CSCD. Okay, so from this what we are understanding, if arcs are congruent, means if APC is congruent to EQD, if APC is congruent to EQD, means arcs are congruent, then these chords are also congruent, means which if they are inscribed, that is AC is congruent to ED. And how we prove? From this we have to show that here two triangles are formed by using these chords, and if you show these two triangles congruent to each other, then you can show that CSCD, you can show that AC is congruent to ED. When AC and ED are the chords of a circle, therefore they are congruent to each other. Okay, so in this way you can show this. Now we will see next theorem. Now the statement of this theorem is that the corresponding arcs of congruent chords of a circle are congruent, means when if we draw the congruent chords in this circle, suppose here I will draw the congruent chords. This is PQ and here is M. So this is arc PMQ and here, and PQ is a chord. Now I will draw the arc of equal measure of PQ. I am drawing it as it is only. Now I will name it as a RS. So PQ and RS are the two chords. Clear? Are the two chords having equal measure. Means how much is the measure of PQ? Same measure is SR. Now I will join the points OQ, OP, here OR and OS. Okay, the figure is same like the last theorem, and it is the converse of that theorem. What they told you in that theorem, we seen that if chords are congruent, then arcs are also arcs are congruent, then chords are congruent. Here we are going to see if the chords are congruent, then arcs are also congruent. So I will name it here N. So given, we will write at first. So given inside, what will come? That is, O is the center of a circle. Center of a circle. O is the center of a circle, and chord. In last theorem, the arcs was arcs were congruent, but here the chords were congruent. So PQ is congruent to chord RS. Okay, and what we have to prove? We have to prove that is arc PMQ. PMQ is congruent to arc R PMQ is congruent to RNS. Okay, for that we have to use the same just we have to show this PQ OPQ and ORS congruent to each other. If these two triangles are congruent to each other, by CSAT we can show these angles also, which POQ and ROS congruent to each other, and if the angles are congruent, the corresponding angles and radius are congruent, then the corresponding arcs are also congruent. In this way we will prove it. So we see it's a proof. So proof inside, we will take two triangles. First triangle is in triangle OPQ, and another triangle is ORS. Okay, so first of all, PO is congruent to OR. Okay, what I will write here, PO is congruent to side PO. This is side PO is congruent to side OR. Reason behind it is that radii of same circle. Radii of same circle. If circle is same, its radii are also congruent. Okay. Now another PQ is congruent to side PQ is congruent to side RS. RS. Reason is it is given. So here its reason is the given. Next term, this is OQ is congruent to OS. Side OQ is congruent to side OS. Okay, and reason behind it is that same, that is radii of same circle. Okay, after that, if you see SSS means these sides are congruent to each other. First triangles, all sides are congruent to the sides of second triangle. Therefore, triangle OPQ is congruent to triangle ORS by SSS test of congruency. Okay. Once these triangles are congruent to each other, the angles are also, all angles are also congruent. Therefore, we write angle POQ is congruent to angle ROS, and reason behind it is that is the CACT, corresponding angles of congruent triangles. And after that, if these two angles are congruent to each other and the radii are also congruent to each other, therefore these arcs which is inscribed by this angle are also congruent. So we will write here, measure of arc PMQ is equal to measure of arc PMQ is equal to measure of angle is equal to angle POQ. Okay, how much is the PMQ? That much is the measure of POQ. Same here, RSNR or RNS, measure of angle RNS is congruent to, equal to measure of angle ROS. Okay, and its reason is by the definition of measure of, by the definition of minor arc. Okay, so this radius are also same and the what, the chords are also same. So what we have to do here, if these angles are measure of, here I have to write arc, measure of arc, here also measure of arc. Okay, so this arc and angles measure is same because it is a central angle and this is the inscribed arc. So how much is the PMQ, that much is the measure of POQ. And same here, MNS is how much is the measure of MNS, same is the measure of ROS. Okay, and therefore if these are same and here angle POQ is congruent to, means these two are, means RHS is congruent to each other, therefore LHS is also congruent to each other. So we will write, therefore arc PMQ, measure of arc PMQ, right, arc PMQ is equal to measure of arc, this is RNS. Okay, and measure are same means they are equal in measure, therefore arc PMQ is equal to measure of arc PMQ, is if measure is same then they are congruent to each other. So arc PMQ is congruent to arc RNS. In this way we show that the, if the chords are congruent, then the related arcs are also congruent and chords are also congruent. Okay, in this way you can show this congruent to each other, means arcs you can show congruent to each other. Okay, after this we will see the solved examples in our next lecture. Okay, all of you practice these two theorems. Only we have to show these two triangles are congruent to each other by test SSS, and if it is congruent to each other by CACT, these angles POQ is congruent to ROS, and if the central angles are congruent, then inscribed arcs are also congruent to each other because radius also same. Okay, thank you.